You know what it is. You know what we're about, what we're doing, baby.
008.
008. We've made it this far.
Yeah.
Hold on. Coming in with some music there.
Come on, it's not wrestling.
Hey. Why are you touching my mic?
Because you need my pause.
Kitchen talk. Y'all didn't even come in with a song.
Now don't worry about it. Go ahead, hit it, Georgie.
Left a good job down in the city. Ooh, working for the millionaire night and day. And I never lost 1 minute of sleep. Cause I was worried about the way that things might have been.
Okay.
Big wheels keep on turning.
Woo!
Primary keep on burning.
Yeah.
And we're rolling.
Rolling.
Rolling, yeah.
Rolling.
Rolling on the river.
Fuck out of here.
Yeah, you already know what it is. Me and the mother in building, man.
You wanna curse?
Guess who's back?
Guess who's back?
And I'm motherfucking house at Black.
Let me say this. This is the 8th episode of Kitchen Talk. It is not a cooking show. It is not a love show. We are absolutely here. Shout out to my girl, the esteemed, the sex symbol herself.
Yes. Now you call me a sex symbol.
Yeah, you're sex symbol now. Everybody's into Georgie. Everybody's asking about Georgie. You're asking about your legs. You're coming on here with these. With this revealing,
I got regular shorts, Daisy regular Dukes, regular dagger.
Yeah.
You out here? Cutters.
Yeah, you're projecting.
I'm projecting.
You're projecting. Shout out to Georgie to the left of me, your favorite tomboy,
yes,
AKA Hello, Angela everybody. Davis. You know, and my guy, my brother.
Now go all the way.
No, I got something for this nigga.
All right, go ahead.
Ricky Hustlehard, a.k.a. Fat Ricky.
Rick!
Full Street.
A.k.a. Astronaut Rick.
Astronaut Rick.
A.k.a. I'ma jump in when I have to. Fuck out of here.
You gotta do what you gotta do.
Your mic is not even supposed to be on yet.
Ball me.
All right?
I'm in my bag today.
Yeah. You wait till I introduce you.
All right, ball me.
All right? Shout out to my guy, Petey, over there.
Hey, Petey.
A.k.a. McNugity.
Busting his chest like a milk down to his genitals.
Let happiness consume you, Petey.
And big shout out to Alyssa Jolie. Out here, you know, we got some cooking going on. And you's a fucking hater, boy.
What is your problem?
Yeah. He's a hater.
Stop doing that. Don't do that.
Listen, don't worry about this.
We went to the same school, nigga.
You never went to the school she went to.
What school she went to?
Holy Trinity, nigga.
Let me introduce this nigga.
You definitely.
Alexa, let me introduce this nigga.
Yeah. Do it properly.
We have an honorary cast member.
Second time. Justice League.
I don't know why he's here.
Well, you know why I'm here.
This is Kitchen Talk, not Justice League.
This is Kitchen Talk, bro.
You're right.
This is Kitchen Talk. You're in my home.
Avengers are better.
No, we like Justice League. But we like the Justice League. This is what we like. I'm Batman, Superman, he's Robin. All right? I'm Batman and Superman, he's Robin.
Both Robins, right?
No, Robin Hood.
The nigga with how you doing, man? Thank you for having me back. Appreciate it. You know, got some good feedback. You know, I'm gonna be honest.
Whoa. We don't want you talking yet.
Hey, right? He just
talking.
Whoa.
I touch y'all live.
You talking?
I had about almost 800 niggas watching your shit live. Thank me.
Thank you me for later. What?
Hold on. I got this one.
Uh oh.
Trevor, I'm gonna need you to just relax.
What was the most you had in there?
Just a little bit. This is Kitchen Talk.
What was the most you had in there? I'm sorry.
But I'm gonna need you to relax.
But what was the most?
It doesn't matter. It was 300 the most.
When Flip was on there with 800.
We're not talking numbers here.
I love you, Georgie, but it's between me and
him. Did you forget them numbers I did on your show, nigga?
She didn't bring that up.
Did you forget that?
I didn't forget that. Thank you.
All right, then, 500,000. So stop playing with me, nigga.
Ooh, half a ticket?
Stop playing with me, nigga.
I touched your show. And I made it nice. It was already nice. I was just the topping on the cake.
Okay, here's the thing.
It was already ill.
Here's the thing, Flip. You touched the show, but you can touch the floor. Okay? You can touch the floor, Flip. All right? I don't want to mess that nice little Gucci shirt up.
Don't get that cream shirt dirty.
Yeah, don't want to mess it up, man. Listen. Slow your roll, man.
I got two of them. Have one in the trunk just in case it gets dirty.
You just, okay. That's good. That's
so
good.
Now that we've invited you into Kitchen Talk, would you like to share the topics with us as well as we talk?
Well, this is Maino's show, so this is y'all's show.
This is our show. I want to talk about something that I've been seeing and that I've seen this past week. And I just want to run through it because it involved a homie of mine, right? And it's... We all are familiar with reality TV, right?
Yes.
Yes.
I saw something this week that really it really bothered me. You know, I saw the homie being construed as an angry woman beater.
Oh yeah, I didn't appreciate that either.
And I was just like, wow. You know, they put a clip out on my man Votto.
Shout out to Votto.
And
shout out to Votto.
Before anybody understood what was going on, before anybody understood what was happening, there was this idea that he was just some angry person. You understand? And that he was just an abusive boyfriend or what have you. And not to say that any amount of violence towards a woman is good. I'm just saying. But it was a whole story. You understand? It was a whole story of him being basically abused verbally and as well as physically also. You understand? So it was just something that I wanted to talk about because reality TV for me is like I did one season of Love and Hip Hop, right? I did 8 episodes. And it was something that I always told them. It was that it's important for me. If I'm going to do this, I can't come on here and damage myself more than I'm already am. I need to walk away with my integrity. I need to walk away and still be the same nigga that I am.
Absolutely.
I can't go on reality TV and allow the cameras and the producers to put me in a situation that I can't face the people after that. What I'm going to tell niggas in the hood? What I'm going to tell my people? What I'm going to tell the homies? What I'm going to tell anybody, the family, if we up there, we allowing them to make us look crazy? So I just felt like it was just a bigger story. And I don't want nobody to take my words the wrong way, like I'm condoning any amount of violence in any kind of way because towards a woman, because that's not what I'm talking about. Mm-hmm. I'm saying that it was a bigger story. It was a bigger issue because anybody know Votto know that Votto is like a real cool, smooth, calm and collective kind of guy. You understand?
I never seen him raise his voice.
Never. Never. What you thought about that, Flip?
It wasn't a good look. Shout out to Votto. It's unfortunate that the cameras displayed that clip. Hopefully.
Right.
Hopefully we be able to see the whole thing. I don't condone it.
I mean, the whole thing.
Oh, you did?
Right.
I didn't.
She had hit him with apple. Some oranges or something
in
like
his
that.
His face, yeah. I mean, you know, with Votto. You know, we got wind blowing. Give me a second. Can you turn that off, love? Thank you.
Shut your mouth.
We went to the same school. Come on, you know better than that, Alyssa. I taught you well. This is my thing. You know, a lot of things happen, man, but certain things are not for TV.
Right.
You know what I mean? And you were one of the people that came out of reality TV.
I didn't come from reality TV.
I'm about to fix it. Pardon me.
I did 8 episodes.
Yo, shut up and let me fix it.
You understand?
Let me fix it.
Fix it.
You a person that went... I'm not ready to fix it now.
Fix it.
You a person that went on reality TV and came with your credibility intact. A lot of niggas go on there and fuck up. They try to invite me to Love and Hip Hop.
Integrity.
Yeah, integrity.
It's integrity. Mm-hmm. So... I never wanted to be on reality TV because it was important for me. I'm positive because it was important for me. It's important for me to not step into a realm that I can't control. And then when I walk away from it, then I'm more damaged than when I stepped in.
But you did a great job.
You understand?
Everybody's not you.
Right.
Everybody's not you. And on top of that,
but some people demand what they want. And if it's not right, then they... Like you said, some people don't compromise their integrity. My integrity and my character is more important than the bag.
Understood.
You know what
some
I mean?
People need
we made them get the bag.
But under a certain type of terms, it was a compromise and it was a negotiation. But it wasn't like, oh, I'm going to take this bag and do what y'all want me to do. No, this is what I stand for. This is what I want to do. And we can work this out. We can negotiate in between the numbers and the direction that I'm going in. Correct?
It's a slippery slope. You're 100% right. It's a slippery slope because most people think they look at the opportunity that the TV going to bring them. And they think like, you know, it's going to help the music. I personally don't think that reality TV helps music at
nothing
all.
Nothing helps anything.
It's making more popular.
It just makes you popular in a certain
the people
a certain
that
realm.
Don't even probably buy music.
Yeah.
But the thing is, it doesn't. Music is funny within itself because you can make music, but it might be other things within that. It's not just about making music. It's about what you do with that music. It's about the things that you do. Now, like you said, reality television, it really doesn't help music because people are focused on your storyline more than what you're doing.
See, but that's the thing. You see what you just said? See, look, hold on. Yeah. You're rolling that. You're rolling that.
Call me butter.
Get your mic shut off and cut the fan. Right? Slow up. Slow up. What I'm saying is that what you said is absolutely right, but a lot of people sit on the sidelines and look at the opportunity that reality TV gonna bring them and feel like, you know what? I got my music career. I'm going to go on a reality show and then I'm going to be on there and then it's going to blow my music up. One don't have nothing to do with the other. One does not have nothing to do with the other. Mm-hmm. Music is music. Reality TV is reality TV. You can do both. It's just like being an actor,
right,
an actress, whatever it is, a producer, whatever it is. But I just think that when you're going into that type of shit, you gotta be careful. You understand? Because them cameras is on, and you have absolutely no control over what they're gonna put out, how they're gonna chop it up, none of that. So when I would have hated to been in that situation.
Yeah.
I would have hated to have been in that situation where it was like I'm looking a certain kind of way in front of the world. Mm-hmm. And this is not the time to be playing with females like that.
Mm-hmm.
We got one mad black woman over here right now.
That's the Me Too movement going on.
Yeah, you are a mad black woman. Yeah.
You don't want that.
Yeah, you don't want that. You don't want no parts of that.
Well, at the end of the day, I mean, I'm a well-controlled individual. But like you said, when it comes to embarrassment is a big thing on either end. He's embarrassed and she's probably embarrassed. You know what I mean? Because now you look like a victim. Like me, I don't like, as a woman, I don't play victim at all. I don't even like people looking at me as a victim. So that would have pissed me off within itself. And for him, you know what I mean? They're not even showing what transpired before that. So now I look like I'm just out here just being enraged, putting my hands on a woman, not realizing, and y'all don't even know that it was provoked in that type of way. And unfortunately, he lost control of the situation.
Right. I mean, listen, we're human and things happen. So like, and the problem with that is that as a man, the burden is on you at all times.
Mm-hmm. You're always in the wrong.
You're always in the wrong, no matter what. No matter,
it's unfortunate.
No matter what happens, you are always in the wrong, and especially if it's something that's being viewed by the camera. If it's footage, they don't want to hear nothing.
And the majority of the viewers are females.
Yo, let me tell you something. I was accused of putting my hands on a female. You remember that, Rick?
You was accused?
You don't remember? I got locked up.
We was accused.
Yeah, but I was in the paper. They said me. They said I karate chopped up, kicked and all that.
But we was accused.
Yeah, but
I went through it too.
You went through it, but not like me.
I think it was kind of worse though.
How? Because they came into your house.
Yeah, I was sleeping. They were standing over my bed.
But I was in the newspapers.
Oh, that way, yeah.
That was embarrassing.
Because they didn't know me yet.
He had it worse. You're a sucker. We don't shut this mic off. Let me tell you something.
Yeah,
I went to a club. Griffin. Anybody know in New York City, remember what Griffin Nights used to be?
Those were good nights.
Great nights. And I had it was this girl that was texting me, and I was just like, all right, we about to leave. Come pull up. Now, when I walked out the club, I had about maybe like 15, 20 people with me. I had a car parked right out front. So I told her, like, you know, what's happening? So she jumped in the car with me, and I was like, okay, we out. She was like, we going to get some breakfast? I was like, nah. She said, okay, you want to take me home? I was like, nah. So she was like, you're not going to take me home? I was like, take you home? Like, I didn't bring you here, okay? You didn't come with me. You text me. I thought you was texting me because you wanted a situation to happen. I thought that you was thinking the same thing that I was thinking. I thought that maybe we were on the same page, but obviously we wasn't. I didn't even pull off. I'm sitting right in front of Griffin. It was madness out there. Anybody remember Griffin Nights? It used to be crazy.
Facts.
On Monday nights at Griffin. So what happened was she got mad. You remember I used to wear the crown? You know, anybody?
Kelby? I saw it. It's bent up.
Yeah, it never bent up.
It's bent downstairs.
So she started cursing me out. She started cursing me out. Oh, motherfucker, your Burger King crown wearing ass, motherfucker. Ah. Burger King. And I was like, all right, cool. So what happened? The police was out there and they came to my car and they was like, Mano, what's going on? I was like, look, I just want her to get out. She got out the car, right? And I thought that that was the end of that. A day later, I'm sitting over on an interview with DJ Envy. He was like, the police looking for you. I said, the police ain't looking for me, nigga. What the police looking for me for? Do I look like the kind of person that the police would be looking for?
You were. You were.
It's a trick question.
Yeah, it was a trick question.
Trick question, bull out, right? So hold on.
We're gonna be looking for you for that.
Yeah, definitely not that. So what happened was, I'm chilling, and then I got a call from K Slay. He's like, yo, man, this girl, she talking about she going to the police. And I'm like, police for what? I ain't do nothing. And then I got a call from Angela Yee in the morning, like the next morning. She was like, yo, this girl tried to call up and say that you did something to her. I said, did what? That you put your hands on. I said, hell no. But I'm thinking it's a game because the police was there. The police saw that we were in plain sight. It couldn't have been an issue, right? So I was like, okay, it ain't nothing. And then come to find out, I'm going about my day, and then I'm in the papers. I'm in the New York Post. Police are looking for New York rapper Mano to talk to him in a case that involved him assaulting a female. I said, what? This is how I find out about it. I find out about it through the Post. So I called my lawyer up and I'm like, look, this is some bullshit. I didn't do nothing. I didn't do nothing. And it talked in the paper, it talked about how I kicked her. Karate chopped her. Like, I swear to God, I couldn't be making this up. You think I'm joking?
You got the paper here?
I didn't even want to think about this shit like that.
It was like a souvenir clipping that we
wanted. Yeah, nah, that's not, yeah, that's not the type of news I want. And to make a long story short, I had to turn myself in for something that I did not do. For something that was so made up. What happened was she was so embarrassed about getting out of the car in front of everybody that she wasn't made this story up on me. And I had to turn myself in, go through the system, come out court, cameras is, and all types of shit is outside. And I'm like, oh, I'm really going with this. And people was killing me. Girls, women were killing me. And I never could say nothing. I never could have an opportunity to say nothing because it was like, don't say, saying nothing sometimes is best. People was like, oh, you woman beater. Oh, you assaulting women. You putting your hands on women in club. I'm like, I never even put my hand on that lady's leg. I never touched her hand. And what eventually happened is that they found out that she was lying. And they threw it out. But that was a small article. The lie is always better than the truth. So I say that to say that you never know what the whole full situation is, because people just gonna jump the gun, especially when you're a man. That they don't want to hear nothing. If they say you did it, nigga, you did it.
Word.
You did it.
So meanwhile, while that's happening, police looking for me. Because she told him I hit in the head with a champagne bottle.
That's a fact.
So I'm in home in the bed. And then I roll over. Feel somebody nudging me. I look up. They stand over my bed. Like, I get dressed. Come with us. What I do? Assault. With a weapon. They try to lock me up with assault with a weapon. But luckily, I had footage.
Yeah, you had the footage, yep.
Had the footage of her trying to, you know, cursing me out, attacking me, calling me the N-word.
Yeah.
She's a Caucasian woman. So once the lawyer sent that to the DA, they threw that out.
You were scared, though. You left that part out. You I called me. Scared. You scared. Your voice
you
was very
you turned yourself in.
Trembling.
I mean, catch me in traffic.
No. I had no choice.
Uh-huh. You turned yourself in.
I had no choice,
had to catch, right or wrong, they had to catch me in traffic.
I'm jacking that.
You jacking that?
Suck
your
ass.
Your voice was,
you're a sucker.
Your voice was trembling.
You turned yourself in, nigga.
Chase your dream.
Listen, I turned myself in. I had no other choice.
You did. You're right.
I had no other choice. Where I'm going. Nigga.
Nowhere.
I had a bullshit warrant for peeing in the street. They showed up the Aces and locked me up. So where am I going?
Why were you peeing in the street?
Because he was mad at me and jumped out being an asshole.
Yeah, because he playing. I had to go.
Yeah.
And as soon as I jumped out, I was angry. I peed in the street, and it had to be cops. The next call coming out of the block.
He jumped out at the light. He jumped out at the light. And started peeing. Police, boop, boop.
And they gave me a citation. Wow. They gave me a citation. Right? They wrote me a little ticket. I never replied to it or whatever. And then when I was booked to host Aces.
Okay.
Right?
I
pull up in front of Aces, a couple of trucks. We look, I see police out there. I say, who they waiting for? Shit, they ain't waiting for us. And I go to walk in, and they was like, you, come on. I said, what? And they was there to lock me up. I thought it was something big because they had maybe like 20 police out there. I'm like, this is it. This is some shit. This is it. And man, I get in the car, man. I was like, officer, can you tell me what I'm being locked up for? And he said, you had a warrant. A warrant for what? A summons. A summons for what? Urinating in the street. Urinating in the street?
Run the whole force out for this?
Cuz, man, you know, you come with a lot of energy.
Hip-hop police.
Oh, man.
You come with a lot of energy, man.
And what energy is that, Flip?
made them nervous. They had to be cautious with you.
Well, you know what type of, you know what energy I have.
And what kind of energy is that?
Big dick energy.
We're going to shut her mic down.
Do it for real.
We gonna have to. Do it for real. The thing is, people take things that they see on face value, bro. Mm-hmm. You understand? I'm not here to justify no type of behavior.
Yeah.
And I'm not the type of nigga that speak down on shit, because I done did probably the most craziest things in my life. In my lifetime, I done did some shit that I can't take back. You understand? So, you know, I'm not here to pass judgment on nobody. You're shaking your head, Flip.
Well, we're happy that you're doing better.
I'm doing great.
And I'm happy. You know, I see you, I speak to you, and, you know, you make me happy.
Really? He makes you happy.
He makes me extremely happy.
What was that?
You were mean to me today.
Who? I mean, Flip? You know.
No, you.
Oh, don't put me in that. I mean, you know.
So you speaking for him?
No, I'm speaking for me. Because he said you make him
he
happy.
Makes me extremely happy. Said, he's a great friend.
And you looked at
he's
me.
He's a great mentor.
Yes.
What the?
He is. He annoying, but he is.
He ain't annoying. I mean, I guess, you know, y'all was sharing pictures earlier, so I guess that's what, you know, you got to help about that.
Nah, nobody shared your Flip. Is this something that you want to talk about?
It's
an elephant in the room.
Get off your chest.
No, it's
an elephant. I want to talk about.
Get off your chest.
It's something that you want to talk about. And here's the thing, though.
What's the problem?
You're spilling water.
The problem, I don't think, is with me.
Yeah, what's
the problem? The problem is not with me.
What the problem?
It's a deeper issue that Flip got.
Wait, hold on.
Let me talk.
My problem is with you from earlier today, nigga.
It don't matter. It's an issue that you got. It's an underlying issue. It's an elephant in the room. And the elephant ain't got nothing to do with me. It got everything to do with you. Georgie?
Daisy Dukes?
Really?
Danny? Yes.
Really? No, it doesn't.
Yes, it does.
I was just with Georgia yesterday.
Oh, she smoked you too.
Yeah, she did.
She smoked you.
We got a lot of calls about it. I was just speaking to Cam. So I was going to shout him out.
Shout out Cam.
Yeah, he was saying
if y'all ain't catch that.
But look, I want to say something.
Go to Georgia Instagram and watch the smoke.
You want to run this conversation or can I?
But I just want to say, there's something going on. There's something going on with you. And when it comes to Georgie, like it's like you, it's this unsaid thing. It's this thing that hasn't been, you haven't got closure, have you?
Closure from what?
From what?
From the letdown. Oh. From the letdown.
Let me say this real quick. So, you know.
It never fails.
Today, spoke to Cam. Aunt Deb called me back last night.
Shout out to Cameron, man.
Aunt Deb was like, yo, there's something going on with you and that young lady. Y'all seen Cam. Everybody said, and I'm like, nah, that's my peoples. You know, we did a great video. She said, nah, I watch a lot of rap videos and it's something dead. I'm like, nah, it's my peoples, Aunt Deb. She said, you know, you got to tell me everything if we're going to be doing business. And Cam, I saw Cam, he saw the rap, and he was asking me, he sat me down, and, yo, Flip, you, let me tell you something. Georgie's a friend of mine. It's my peoples, you know.
But it's something else there. Let's be honest. Don't come on kitchen talk.
I think
talking stupid,
nigga. I think people misconstrue the fact that you know, we work together and we work good together, they mix it for something else. That's just my people.
We tell all truth on this podcast.
I tell any truth. That's my people. We work well together. And I had to explain that to them. It's the bond. I mean, I don't know what people are seeing. And I really don't care. At the end of the day, you know, the truth of the matter is that's my friend.
Okay.
And I think it's just the bond that people are misconstruing for something else.
Okay. You kissed somebody else in the battle.
He kissed me on the cheek.
You authorize that?
Let me say this, because you're not keeping it real. Now, I told you before, it's real nigga etiquette, bro.
Okay.
It's a real nigga handbook.
Sure.
Don't come on here with this elephant in the room and not be honest.
What elephant in the room you're talking about? That's my friend.
You might not be lying, but don't come here telling half truths.
Yeah, be honest.
What's the half truth?
So
you why don't you tell me the truth?
Okay, the truth is this. Y'all both are friends.
Yes.
Y'all work together.
Yes.
Y'all did business together.
Yes.
But you also was in love with her.
No.
You wasn't in love with her?
No.
You wasn't in love with her?
Love is a strong word. Nah, I wasn't in love with her. I was.
You wanted to be with her?
No, I did not.
What did you want from her?
I was infatuated with the way she thought, her thinking process.
And the way she looked?
No.
What the fuck out of here?
No. At the end of the day.
You were infatuated? That's the word you're going to use?
I was infatuated.
So you were infatuated with the thought of me and not the reality?
Let her talk.
You heard me? You were infatuated with the thought of me, but not the reality.
Let me say.
I was asking a question. I don't know.
I was infatuated.
You're stuttering.
Infatuated.
You stuttering,
slow
boy.
Down.
You gotta let me.
You stuttering,
mean,
boy.
Don't you got some situations you got involved in that I heard about today?
His mic is cut off.
I'm gonna talk about that too.
His mic is cut off.
I'm not talking about nothing. I'm cool and how I'm cool. All right, that's so how that's what I'm saying.
So don't you know? So once I pass something on, let's. This is my thing. This is my friend. We do good business together. At the end of the day, I was infatuated with how she thought. I liked her around because she was good with business. She was encouraging in certain things. That's all it was.
And
it stopped
there. And that's not true. And you was attracted to her also.
She's a beautiful girl, but...
Were you attracted to her? Flip?
She was a beautiful...
Yo, Flip, don't do that. Don't
she's a beautiful woman.
You're going to get kicked out the house.
So I'm fine with that.
Her
she's
being
a beautiful
woman, were you attracted to her?
No, not in that way.
You're a fucking liar.
What way was you then?
That's my friend. I think that...
You're a fucking liar, Trevor.
That's cool. I was more attracted to the way she thought. Let me say
you
this.
You liked her, nigga. Say it. It's okay.
I'm around women all day.
It don't matter.
Stop.
It's okay. You liked her.
Let me finish.
You liked her.
Let me finish. That means I like all the women I'm around. I'm about building women. Entrepreneurship, nigga. That's what I'm around. They come back. Not her, that's my people. We never lost a friendship, but that's it. I'm friend zone flip. You know why? I let niggas like you. No disrespect to you in a situation. I let niggas like you deal with all that. I'm an entrepreneur, nigga. I put a bag in their pocket. They have no choice but to love me. They go home and think about me in their bed.
You know, this nigga,
he showed me how to get the bag, period.
You built
all
like,
that other shit. I'm not in love with nobody, nigga. She trying to add up souls. Don't put ketchup on the
spinach. No.
She had a good mind.
Jabba.
Let me talk. Let me get it out. She got a great mind. And I liked her around.
And you wanted her.
She was good for business. No, I didn't.
You're a liar.
I'm here. I hope y'all know I'm like right here.
Fuck him. You know why? Jabba.
She was good for
Jabba the Hutt.
You just gonna pretend
listen
like I'm not here. Okay. Yes. You just gonna talk for me.
You came to the studio.
Okay.
You came to see me.
Yes.
You sat down with me.
I'm taking off.
And you said to me, you
Jermaine?
Said, no, he told me.
Jermaine.
He told me he liked you.
Jermaine.
And no, because he's coming to my home and he's been
disrespectful. But this is not what we're talking about here. This is not what we're talking about here.
No, this nigga coming in here with all this energy.
No. This is not what we're talking about.
Fuck that. Oh, no, wait. Hold on. Pull me. Give me a second.
No.
I
sat down. You came to my studio and you told me what it was. Be honest.
The studio that's not mine. Let me say this.
You're in the little room.
You're in my sex room.
Stand
your game up, Rick. I have three rooms.
No, you don't.
I have three rooms.
No, you don't.
It's all right.
There's three rooms in there.
Yeah, he got.
I have four rooms in there. I got three.
You got three of them.
But thank you, Mano.
On the little one don't count.
Okay, so I got the two big ones. Let me say this. I came in. We was talking about a situation that happened.
Be honest.
Because at a time I was in a very.
Let me finish.
Be honest.
I was in a very bad place. So at a time when Georgie was in the studio, I used to do things and bait her into arguments. I was just taking things out on her. So when I came to talk to you, it was more about my behavior. Like, yo, you know, don't shake your head like that. I'm telling you, it was more about my behavior towards her because you had to make me realize I was in a bad place. But as far as any emotional or liking, no, wrong guy.
Let me talk, Flip.
That was my friend. I told you it was an incident that happened. I took full responsibility. That's my friend. We do good business.
We're friends.
And that's it.
We're cool.
Y'all are friends. Y'all good friends. Man, shut the fuck up, Rick.
Don't talk to Rick like that, nigga. Flip. Don't talk to
you. Talking to you, Flip. Talking to you. Yeah. Here's the thing.
You embarrassing her.
No, I'm not embarrassed. This is my sister. This is my baby. She been with me for 70 years.
70 years.
What that got to do with me?
She been around me.
40 years. 40 years, yeah.
She been around me
for
a long time, okay? Now, what I'm saying to you is this. You're not keeping it all the way 100. And you talk to Aunt Deb. Aunt Deb is going to watch this. And she's going to say, Flip is not keeping it real. I thought Flip was a real
name. Can we get Georgie...
Well, let me just say this. On Deb or on Deb, and people are seeing something that's not there. My answer stays
no,
the same. Let me say on Deb, like, yo, Flip, I watch all your shit, but it's something about that girl. Y'all, so
everybody bugging.
Everybody bugging. They bugging. They see, I'm more infatuated right, with the
Georgie.
Mind.
I'm gonna fuck on, him up. No, I'm gonna fuck this nigga up. No, I'm fucking him up. No, I'm fucking you up.
You know why?
No, I'm fucking you up, nigga. Like this.
They think it'll be a good show.
How you gonna come to my house?
You should do a show.
Yeah, you lie. You coming to my house and lie?
That's my people.
You come to my house and lie to me?
Couch and lie.
You sit on my couch and lie.
I'm around women all day, man. You know that. You know that, nigga. You know Ivy, nigga.
You disrespecting my family, nigga.
I'm around them all day, nigga. I'm around women all day. I like all the women I'm around. I like all the women that I work with. Yeah, meet my mic.
Yeah.
I'm around all the women that I work with.
Yeah, muted.
What are you talking about, nigga?
No, shut the fuck.
I like all the this women nigga, I work with, nigga. I make entrepreneurs, females, nigga. Holler at me if you want to get the bag. Holler at me, man. Listen.
Can I just make something?
Let Georgie talk.
Let Georgie talk.
But because you know what I'm saying, and then listen, Georgie, I'm not trying to here to make you. I'm not here to make
somebody pass the a paper situation down
right there, please. Uncomfortable or none of that. But he got this energy. This is like this elephant in the room. It's like this unsaid.
I feel he looks tense up
and
a little bit.
Yeah, when he around you, and he's not keeping it all the way 100.
I wasn't tensed up. I was tense.
Nobody's talking to you, bro.
Can I speak? Number one, you can create entrepreneurs all you want to, but I created myself, and I am who I am, and I'm going to be who I be. That's number one. Mm. All right? So I'm going to let your ego.
Hold up.
That had nothing to do with you.
Listen. Listen to what I'm saying.
See, for the viewers, she let me know.
I'm just letting it be known.
Got it.
Okay?
Mm-hmm.
Number two. Me and you are very good friends.
Yes, okay? We are.
We've had our differences, and we are working towards moving past those differences because I'm a forgiver, okay? And I'm also a person who doesn't let their emotions get the best of them, and I like to move forward. Business is business. That's how I am, and I handle business. I don't care about none of that other shit anybody's talking about, okay?
Hold on.
She in a row.
You just got checked.
No, he didn't get checked.
And
I don't want you to think that you got checked.
Place.
But what I'm saying is, we look at things a little differently.
She did.
And let's be honest, Flip is a lot more emotional than I am. And sometimes that gets in the way because he doesn't understand.
You just ran up his chest.
No, he just doesn't understand my
reactions on his chest.
When they're not his reactions. That's
you walked
all.
Up his titties.
But he understands.
You ran up his titties.
But I just wanted to make that
you
clear.
You ran up his titties!
Can you stop being an instigator?
No, stop. Because
I'm going to check you in 2 seconds too. Knock
his
it off.
Titties.
You're being a kid right now.
She did.
Now, I'm just saying that just to say, like I said, me and him are cool. Me and him, it's nothing more, nothing less. Me and Flip are building a better friendship than we had before, and that's what's happening here.
So it's only a friendship.
It's only a friendship.
But can I ask you a question?
Did he ever try to cross that friendship line?
Yes, be honest. Be honest.
This is kitchen talk. She know better to lie.
Flip has made little gestures.
Like what kind of
I'll
gestures?
I'll say that. Yeah, like that's personal. Like that, that don't have nothing to do with kitchen
like
talk.
He wanted more
It really doesn't matter because at the end of the day right now me and Flip are friends.
We know it
and
doesn't
that's
matter.
What it is.
We asking you, was the gestures hitting toward being more than just business friends?
Girl, I know this might seem strange, but let
I can
me
respond?
Know if I'm no. out of
for
order for
stepping to you this way. See, I've been watching you for a while.
Hey,
let me say this first and foremost. Listen, we're not gonna allow our egos or pride to get in the way.
Yes.
You got checked, nigga.
I did. Let me say this first and foremost. When I was talking about entrepreneurship, I wasn't referring to you at all because. You know, at the end of the day, you know.
All you had to do is answer the question. That never came out.
Stop. I gotta respond to this because I don't want to offend the people out there that actually that I'm actually working with that actually we do business with. So I don't want to offend the ladies. So I have to make this correction. As far as business with me and you, you know, we busy. You my nigga. So I wasn't referring to you about entrepreneurship at all. That had nothing to do with you.
I appreciate that.
That was more towards Mano. We were talking about something earlier.
No, I don't hear that.
But no, it had nothing to do with her. Nah. Because we don't have that sort of, we working on something. We don't have that sort of business. She got her own thing going on. Mm-hmm. I got my own thing going on. So if it didn't apply to her. But I appreciate her putting that out there for the viewers, mm-hmm. just in case they thought. Second thing is, as far as the emotional part, I agree.
Be honest.
I tend to be emotional. So I agree. At the same time, I don't think that I was being emotional here. I think that what it was is that...
You like them, bro. No, it's okay.
He's talking about something.
I don't think I was being emotional here at all. Actually, I don't have an issue. This is something between me and Mano. You cool. You know what I'm saying? You my nigga. So that's where we keep it at. You know what I mean?
Georgie.
Okay, okay. If it don't apply, let it fly. At the end of the day, you know, when it comes to friendship, understanding, bonds, this is what we got, me and Georgie. And we leave it at that. Let me say this.
There's a question like Rick Ross. Word, man. This man, point.
What do you want me to say? You want me to say something that's not true?
We want you to just be real.
We want you to just go, okay.
Just not
be real.
That's it. Just
you
say
come,
okay.
You come to my house.
You get baited all the time. This
you
is
come
just
to my
bait.
Home this and you lie. Not, to, you lie in my home.
Georgie,
that's
we had a whole conversation before this. This is why you know Georgie.
Mom's downstairs. You lying for
what? What do you want me to answer?
You lie. You coming to my home lying?
What do you want me to answer?
You like Georgie? It's okay.
No, I don't.
You liked her. You wanted.
Ed.
You wanted,
no, I did
ED.
Not.
You
so past tense.
Make that make sense just now.
Yeah, make that make sense.
So you liked past tense.
He said like. No, I don't. He said ED. I said ED.
Like.
No, I don't. I don't like her. I didn't or I don't. Both. I didn't.
All right, we're going to go past this, man.
Thank you.
He ain't going to keep it real.
You ain't never going to keep it real, man.
Keep it real with your dog no matter what.
That's a fact, bro.
I'm saying, what do you want me to say at the end of the day? Like,
It is what it is. You just leave it. It is what it is.
Yeah, let me tell you something. Let me just say something. What's
that energy? What's called energy, Georgie?
Big dick energy.
You know.
Relax.
I don't know what that is.
Me either, but I just like what she said.
She's satisfied.
You know, real nigga handbook shit, right?
Yeah.
Real nigga etiquette.
Yeah.
That lying shit.
I'm not lying to you.
Let me just talk. You got to keep it real with your niggas no matter what. Okay? No matter what. No matter if it hurt.
It don't hurt.
You think he don't know all my deepest, dark secrets? He done caught me in the worst, craziest situations, and I keep it real with him no matter what. I say, yeah, I did that. I did that. I ain't had no business doing that, but I did it. You understand?
Got you.
Yes, look
it
at me.
It feel better, too, when you just let your nigga know.
Yeah. Yes.
My thing is that you got to understand, like, there's a lot of things going on. Let me say this. A lot of things are going on, and at the end of the day, I don't know what answer y'all want to hear,
when did you ever say at the end of the day?
The answer that I would give you is that a lot of people, and I'm going to say this because somebody had called me and asked me something, and I'm going to say this. A lot of people, they settle for temporary fixes instead of the long haul.
Right.
And they settle, they'll take the wood off the ladder, could go to the top, but they'll take the wood off the ladder and put it and make a fire. Now they can't get to the top anymore. It's a temporary fix. And
somebody just told him that.
Yeah, it's a temporary fix.
He just heard that.
No, I didn't. And I'm here to say this to all the people that watch this, to all the people that said they saw me a Mano show, and I'm on this forgiving spree. I would say, you know, like the people that have that fell for the temporary fix, man, don't worry, come daddy's home. I forgive you. I forgive you all. I forget everybody. A lot of people make the mistakes and they gotta realize.
Look, I sneezed.
Women know a real nigga. A woman know a real nigga. Women know a nigga about his money. And a nigga know when a nigga about opportunities. And on top of that, you want me to answer a question that I answered four times.
Okay, cool. We ain't gonna ask that question.
Did I like Georgie?
You know what?
No. Did I like who she was? Did I like how she did business? And who? Yes, I did.
Aunt Deb is gonna be mad at you. You a fucking liar. Check. She gonna
she
be mad at you.
She gonna be doing reality show with her. But listen,
hold on. Ain't no listen. This is my home. You come in my home. You come in with lies. You come in here with falsehoods. With fake news. You disrespect my home.
You disrespect my
home.
That Comcast shit.
Huh? You come in here with this Comcast VH1 answers. Huh? This is what you do to me? I came on your show. I gave you shit. I talked about my street shit, my legendary beefs in the street with niggas.
Thank you.
Legendary shit.
I love you for that.
Okay.
You made a classic.
Nobody else had.
Nobody that I first talked time. About things that I never talked first about time on your show. Time. And you come in my home and you disrespect me.
This how? How?
Because you come in here with fake news. You know you like that woman.
I don't like her.
You liked her.
I did like
you wanted something with her.
No, I did not. All right. So this is what I'm going to say. You think that I like her? I'll let you tell it. If I showed that I like her, I'll let you tell it. She answered the question for you.
You know what else women see?
What?
Bullshit.
Boss nigga.
No. You can't say you're a boss. You just got to be that.
I am.
No, stop saying that.
I'm saying it to you.
Stop. No. You're saying it to the world. Stop saying
it. No, I'm saying it to you.
Let me tell you
something. The world know already.
No, the world don't know. Because when you say it, it's unnecessary.
I'm saying it to you because we have a conversation.
I went to the club the other day. It's a clown nigga with a clown suit on, funny chains, funny body, look stupid. And he said he was a boss. What's the difference?
It's a lot.
The male ego is crazy.
It's between, my thing is that why you know what's wrong with you, man?
So crazy. Y'all just been going back and forth.
Because we had it from earlier, Georgie.
But so what? But we sit here. This is kitchen talk. And y'all just being chatty patties right now. Like, at the end of the day, y'all really in y'all ego right now. Just going back and forth about a bunch of nothing.
Shout out to my little man, Queens Flip, man.
Never.
You know, he comes here and, you know.
Little boss, Queens Flip.
Little boss. You know, he out here. He getting the bag. He's making entrepreneurs and all that.
That's a fact.
That.
Want me to show you?
I don't want you to show me.
So watch your mouth. He was on the phone with two of them. Watch your mouth.
Ooh.
Watch your mouth. You know a couple of them, too. It's a different from when you touch him and I touch him. Huh? Oh. It's a difference from when you touch him. You got that big. There's a difference. It's a difference. No more temporary fix. They just came back and you'll flip. I'm sorry. You have to. You have to. Only one person, and she knows who she is, only one person that stand her ground, and I respect that as an equal. Other than that,
who's that?
I don't need to say. She knows who she is. She's around.
No, who
she
is
hear
that?
She hear it.
She hear it. Where she?
It doesn't matter.
Is this her?
Only one person.
Is this her?
And I respect it.
If you talk about who we think you talking about, you taught her well. She know better.
No,
she I'm just gonna saying stay on her ground.
Only one product. I didn't teach her nothing. Only one
product. No, I say you. She see how we. She
yeah. She stays her ground, and that's what it is.
But
and I respect her.
Got to. How can you not? They stood their ground.
Anyway,
at the end of the day, like, let's stop this shit, man. Fuck that. At the end of the day, Georgie, my people, stop.
Oh, so you was talking about Georgie?
Nah, I wasn't talking about
you. You're going to get kicked out and beat the fuck up.
I'm going to leave right now.
You will.
I'm going to leave right now because all you brought on Deb up, and I told you as a secret, you suck ass nigga. You brought up my business on the fucking show. Nigga,
you brought up your business on the show.
Hey, I'm talking
you
to him.
You brought up on Deb first.
Do you understand that when you say I'm talking to him that there is 1, 2, 3, 4 on the show and that we're all one?
I apologize.
So when you talk to him, I can intervene whether you're talking to
him
or not.
No, what I'm saying is that.
No, fuck him.
And you need to relax. You really need to relax. You're on 1,000 right now. You need to really simmer it down and come back.
Him, right?
No, you.
Me?
Yes, you.
Oh.
Knock it off.
Oh, I didn't know.
You keep
letting him pick it. What's wrong with you, man?
Yes, you let him.
We had a conversation from before.
And he pulls you right in.
No, he couldn't disrespect my homie. Disrespect my house.
He pulls you
nigga,
right in.
Nigga, you a sucker
in.
For love ass nigga, man. Like I said,
y'all like two
it's
little
a different
kids.
When, it's a different when I when you touch him and I touch him. Nigga, ask, nigga. Let's sit down and have a meeting about it.
There's
you ill nigga.
All, let me, and you
ill nigga.
They don't let you touch him.
Let me get this.
They don't let you touch him. They don't let you touch him.
Friend zone.
Hold on. Let me
I'm friend zone popping. Fat brosé.
Stop it.
Bro, you brosé?
Let me get this.
Brosé.
Let me explain something to you. Let me explain something. Maybe it's a Brooklyn thing. Maybe it's a difference between Brooklyn and Queens. I don't know.
Don't do that, please.
But when you know, listen. When you know better, you do better. Certain things don't need to be said. You can see it. That's what big dick energy is about.
Oh,
I don't have to say anything. You feel it. You see it.
Oh,
you see my body.
Up top, Danny.
Up top.
I mean.
Hold on. No, shut the fuck up. Hold on.
I mean.
Let's get his mic turned off. No, fuck him. Listen,
I mean, that's cool.
No, we're not fucking with this nigga. Listen, she just ran up your titties again.
I mean,
she just ran right in your chest.
Round of applause for her.
Yes.
Round of applause.
Yeah, his mic is off.
The cameras is on. We can do it for the cameras. Round of applause. I cheer her on, do it. I cheer you on, do it. I cheer you on, do it. At the end of the day, the facts remain the facts. We ain't gonna talk about a Brooklyn and Queens thing. We don't want to go down that alley. Let's keep it in Queens.
Let's keep it in Queens. You in Brooklyn right now?
Pardon me. Let's keep it in Brooklyn. Please don't talk about Brooklyn. Queens. You don't talk about Brooklyn Queens. Slow down.
I can talk about Brooklyn.
Slow down.
We in Brooklyn right now.
You catch a speeding ticket. Slow down.
Never.
Flip this next show.
You're doing 90. You're doing 90. Slow down. You're doing 90.
We allowed you to come back. We allowed you to come back.
Doing 90.
We allowed him to come back, and he's still in my lingo. He gotta relax.
You're doing 90. Slow down.
That's only because he wants you, though.
You don't know who's
cruise control. You're going to crash.
Never.
Because on cruise control,
I ain't crash yet.
We know
on the highway. I ain't crash yet.
We know what a superior borough is.
You done went through a few cars. I ain't crash yet. I'm still driving the same one.
You the same G-Ride?
I'm in the same
Leave
G-Ride.
It alone. Let's bring it back.
A few cars is good.
Let's get back.
It's a good thing it shows leveling.
Not to fuck it up.
Let's get back.
It don't show level up?
After you crash and
you keep going. You keep upgrading. I never went back.
No insurance going to swap you
Michael
out.
Michael Jackson, I don't believe
this
in the moonwalk.
You're crazy. Right.
Let's get back.
Yeah, and I can pay it.
Let's get back. He said.
And I can pay it.
He said.
Oh. There go that Queens.
You know what it is.
That's
about
Little
Queens.
Dick Energy.
I don't want you to. I don't want you to.
That's Little Dick Energy.
It is. It
talking
is.
Talking about what you could pay.
Has nothing to do with you now.
Stop talking about what you could pay.
We got to stop.
All right, stop it.
Next topic.
I got a question.
I
got a question.
Change it.
Could you accept a child that was conceived within your relationship and it wasn't yours?
Georgia, we talked about this.
No. What are you talking about? You bringing it back to the baby on my chest?
No.
Listen.
What are we talking about?
You're in a relationship.
Okay.
Your lady steps out. Okay. And get pregnant. Are you staying with her and raising that child as y'all's?
No.
That's what she's talking about. I told her that
sometimes,
nonsense.
I'm a very prideful person. And sometimes my pride gets in the way of certain things. And sometimes I've made decisions based on my pride. I swallow my blood before I swallow my pride.
Facts. Mm-hmm.
And that's not always a good thing. You understand? It's things that I walked away from that I wanted to keep. But I stayed away from it based on my pride. Now, that I couldn't even negotiate with that. You not only had sex with another nigga, but you let him come in you, okay? That shoot type of shit
up.
Goes in my mind.
He shot the club.
Then
up.
you had his baby, but check this out. I know somebody that happened to. True story. Yep. I know somebody that happened to. I know a friend of mine who was with his girl. No, Rick.
No,
I don't gotta slow up.
Slow up.
I know a friend of mine that was with his girlfriend, and he called me, and he said, "Bro, guess what?" I said, "What's up?" He said, "Yo, me and baby, we having a baby." I said, "You and baby having a baby?" He said, "Yes." I said, "Man, I'm happy for you." I was ecstatic. Then he called me a month later and said, "Yo, the baby might not be mine, by baby." I said, "The baby might not be yours? Who the baby by?"
My peppers, my baby boss.
No, it's not Rick's baby. So here's the thing. He said to me, "The baby might not be mine. The baby might be her ex." I said, "Nigga, you calling me, so you calling me for advice."
Bail money.
You call her up and tell her, "Look, I don't want nothing to do with you. I don't want to see you. I don't want to talk to you. I don't want nothing to do with you because you done violated my trust. And I'm a good nigga." This is what I'm telling him to say because I obviously never was that good nigga. Okay? "I'm a good nigga. I never did nothing for you. For my hand don't call for that. Okay? For you to not only step out on me, but you stepped out raw.
And kept it.
Okay?
Like they don't got plan B."
So now, he didn't take my advice, and they maintained some sort of a relationship, and then she had the baby. The baby's not his. Mm-hmm. They are still together to this day. That is a fact. Now, what you think about that?
He's a good man.
He's a bigger man than me. He's a better man than me.
Bigger, better, everything than me.
But he's what if
stronger man
here's
than
a,
me.
Here's a second
did
question.
Did you hear my story? Did you hear the story? Maybe she didn't hear the story.
No, I said he's a good man.
They was together. What? And she stepped out.
I said he's a good man.
Go ahead, from one point of view.
He's a good man, okay? Now, what if you were raising this kid and then you found out later?
No, hold on. Let's get back to the story.
No, I heard your story. You said he's a better man than you because you couldn't. That was your answer.
Because that's not the scenario you gave me.
Yeah, ask the second question. No, we didn't get there yet.
Well,
the scenario was.
We didn't get there yet.
Okay.
What I'm saying to you is this. Maybe you didn't catch it.
No, I caught it.
They were together. He wasn't even treating. I knew this nigga really well. He wasn't even like that. Like with all the women and all that. Mm-hmm. Like,
he was a good guy.
He was a decent guy. Mm-hmm. Decent guy. And she's a good girl too. But she had a moment. Mm-hmm. I'm not judging her. I'm not even judging their relationship.
Word.
What I'm saying is that she stepped out with her ex. And this is what I told him. I said, listen, bro. She told you that's the first time that happened. This is the way I look at that. Mm-mm. Either that's true or that's a lie. If that's true, if they ain't seen each other in months and the first time they saw each other, they fuck raw, that's his bitch.
Facts.
He got lifetime on that.
Facts.
Yo, a lot of them got lifetime on certain pussies.
Okay. They do. Okay. If you ain't seen a joint in 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 months and you see it and it's like, and you know she got a situation and you know she got a man, you know she with a dude and you still could slide, that's your bitch.
That's your bitch.
Lifetime.
Okay, that's lifetime.
Facts.
I said, so either that happened or she been fucking him. Now, which one you choose to believe? Which one do you choose to believe?
I believe she been fucking him.
I believe she been fucking him too. Cause I would hate to believe that my bitch is just a nigga bitches like that. Like, damn,
your bitches ain't gonna be niggas bitches. Cause your bitches already niggas bitches.
What?
Oh. Yeah, your bitches already
bitches for streets.
Bitches. Yeah. Yeah, your bitches. Well, not.
Well, slow up.
But what if
we'll get back to that?
On. Not my peoples.
Yeah. I'm gonna finish you, but we'll get back to
what
that.
What if the roles were reversed and you stepped out and you had a baby.
Mm-hmm.
But you wanted to be with her.
Okay. All I can ask for is forgiveness. And if I'm not forgiven, then I got to take.
Accept your fate.
I got to accept my fate. I got to accept my senses. I got to. The pain is necessary, but it's always temporary. You understand? The pain is necessary.
Mm-hmm. Because
it's necessary for us to grow. But it's almost always temporary. We'll get through it. So leaving me in a gutter. And putting me down is the way that you need to heal yourself, then that's my fate. And I'm going to accept it. You understand that? Do you understand?
I hear you.
It's kitchen talk.
A lot of faces going on. Uh-huh.
It's kitchen talk. You want to...
What?
Say it again, though.
I'm flowing.
Say it again, though. Kitchen talk.
I'm flowing.
I'm just nigga. Let him no. talk. Whatever he believes and perceives to believe.
I don't think it'll be that easy, but go ahead.
It's never going to be that easy.
No, if putting me down is the way you need to go, then it's okay. If I done something wrong, right? Like had a baby, like you said, that's your scenario, right? Having a child.
Quiet on set.
If having a child is the violation that I caused, and my woman, it says, you just had a baby on me, I can't be with you, you for the streets, nigga. It's time for you to go. I have to accept that because.
So you just gonna pack it up and go?
Yes.
Just like that. That easy.
You might try win her back and try to plead your case, but at the end of the day, if it's over, you fucked up.
Gotta let it go.
He know he fucked up, but you think he's gonna let it go.
But this is my thing, man. Like
he talking like it's gonna be easy, but you know, any man gonna put up a fight.
What about you? How you feel? No, you already said no. What about you, Flip?
As far as what?
If that was to happen.
Oh, yeah, nah, I ain't.
What?
Like, would you be able to accept that?
No. Raise that,
what, if
raise
the,
that baby?
What if the shoe was on the other foot and you had a baby?
I don't. And she does what?
And no, you had a baby, but you still want to be with her. Yeah, or you had a baby in a situation while you still with her.
I would accept whatever happens. like Mano said, feelings are temporary. You know what I mean? We can get over it.
That's not what I said.
But that's how I took it.
I said pain.
Same shit. Pain, feeling, same shit. No, but let me say this to you.
Uh-oh. Sorry, pain, Georgie. Hold on. Is pain a feeling?
Yes. Thank you,
pain
Rick.
Is a feeling.
So yeah. Let me say thank you, Rick.
My nigga.
Watch yourself, Rick. No.
Your bitches. Let me say this to you.
Why? How we going?
Hold on. No, hold on. Wait, Georgie.
Bitches. Wait.
No. Because I'm.
First of all, no.
He can't let shit
Georgie
go.
Let Georgie get another scenario.
He can let it go. They can pack it up and go, but they can't let shit like this go. He's been holding that in for about 20 minutes. Yeah.
What's your other scenario?
All right, Georgie, go ahead. My fault, Georgie.
My other scenario was if you were taking care of the child already. Like, you find out later on, like, this is not your child.
I would still love the child and raise the child because it's too late. How many years has it been? The kid
I don't know.
What?
Let's say it's 4 or 5.
Yeah, it's too late.
I grow an attachment to that child.
That's right. I could.
It's gonna be smoke, but me and the child.
It's gonna be a lot of smoke.
We deep.
It's gonna be a lot of smoke.
A lot of smoke.
Smoke dogs.
Me and that child.
Smokealicious.
Smokey Rob.
Smoke mania.
Word. Train smoke. Hookah smoke.
Car smoke.
Wildfire smoke.
Nasty smoke coming out of the.
I hate y'all so much.
Forest fire smoke.
All types of smoke.
I agree with everybody though. Agree with all.
It's just crazy to me how even you explaining it, like you stepped out and you went raw, and you let a nigga come in you, but niggas do this shit all the time.
Here we go from a woman's point of view. Man,
that's not the point.
Y'all be in full-fledged relationships.
You let a nigga let me ask you a question.
The thing is, if niggas do it, that give it okay for a woman to do it, yes?
No.
All right, so
everybody at the end of the day, I thought you was with equal opportunity.
Yeah, exactly.
He said if a nigga do it, no. He's saying like if a nigga could do it, it means that a woman could do it. I mean, we could do whatever we want to do. Like, I don't believe in the double standard stupid shit.
We know.
Whatever you could do, I could do. Exactly. That don't mean I'm gonna do it. So let's be clear, it could be done.
But at the end of the day, I noticed that you make a lot of excuses.
I don't. There's no excuses.
You give a lot of reasons.
Let him talk. I want him to talk.
I noticed you make a lot of reasonings. For when niggas do foul shit, do you dwell in the foul lane? Hold on, let me get a little deeper. I noticed.
Okay, Flip.
When it comes to
I heard
when it comes to foul shit like cheating or going back to an ex or doing something you tend to like when you talk about it, it's like you making an excuse for it. Like it's okay. Do you dwell in those realms? It's like Mortal Kombat. Are you in that realm? We in different realms. There's realms here. So are you in the realm where if I see something I like, I'm gonna do whatever regardless of the situation? I just wanna know, do you dwell in those realms?
What do you mean, like, do I cheat and do shit like that?
I'm just, do you dwell in those realms?
No, I don't.
Bring me the realms with
you. I'm not a straight shooter, I'm shooting right now, so I need you to
nigga,
shoot right at me.
Nigga, I shot from the hip, bop, it hit you.
Never.
Do you dwell in those realms?
No, I do not. I do,
respect.
But I do believe that whatever you can do, I want you to keep it. See, stop finishing my sentences. You don't know what I'm going to say.
I can do better. I can do better than you.
Of
course you can. Round of applause for my nigga.
I didn't even finish.
Big dick energy in the fucking building.
So you done? Are you finished?
Do you dwell in that realm?
Do you dwell in that realm? Are you going to let me talk?
Let her talk, nigga.
Okay, now.
I'll knock you out. Don't fucking talk about that, nigga.
Let her talk, nigga.
Your bitch is blowing everybody.
What?
I'm able to say that. Sorry.
You just wanted to say that.
Are we going to talk about this?
Don't do that.
He was fiending to say
that. He wanted to say that.
Now, I do not dwell in those realms because I believe in karma. There's good karma and there's bad karma. And what you do is your karma. What I do is my karma. But I want you to understand and get that out your head that, because I'm a man, I could do this. And because you're a woman, you can't. I could do whatever I want to do.
Respect.
No, I'm just, now, I wasn't. Hold
on, hold on.
I could do whatever I want to do. Nobody can stop me from doing anything. But I choose because I have a choice.
But does anybody try to stop you?
Shut.
That's a good question.
Let me.
Don't tell me shut the fuck up.
No, you shut the fuck up.
Nobody tried to stop you.
Georgie, in my opinion, touch your leg like this because it's like.
They try to make little threats.
I don't think nobody tried to stop you. I think that you put that in your mind.
You don't know my relationships, nor anything that I've been through, to even make things to validate you doing it.
Hold on.
Because a nigga will do it.
Hold on.
I don't know what you're doing.
That's the wrong question. The question is.
Pardon me.
you say that you can do anything that anybody else can do, right? Yes. So there's this thing where it's just like men, women, then it's the way that society
yes.
perceives us, right? Yes. I personally don't believe that men that women should try to compete with men with certain things. And I mean, like, if a man is out here being promiscuous, dealing with multiple women, I don't think that the woman should do that. Because don't lose your crown trying to compete with what a man is doing.
Absolutely.
You understand? So don't lose your crown don't become a serial killer, right?
Absolutely. Out here.
Round of applause for you, right? Mano.
Round of applause. You got females, right, that be in relationships. They get out of relationships, and the first thing they do is whole shit. Mm-hmm. Now they may do whole shit based off of the need to feel love, energy, attention, and what they soon find is that the world is cold.
Can I speak on this because I'm a woman?
Now,
grass is not always greener.
The grass, so they think it's greener, and they go out there and they start knocking this guy off because they think it's going to become something, and they find out that it's not going to be. And they knock this
men
guy
do the
off.
Same thing.
Okay. But men are not judged.
Women, yeah.
Men are not
but
judged.
But here's my
way
thing.
That women are.
But here's my thing. First of all,
don't be the I could do just because men do. I could do it because
I am that person.
Okay, but you're judged in a different way though. You're gonna be judged in a different way. Because niggas gonna say, "Oh, that's a whore."
I agree.
Are you gonna let me finish?
That's a slut. I agree.
Are you gonna let me finish?
I agree.
I do believe that women can, if you can do it, I can do it. But nobody heard when I said that just because I said I can do it doesn't mean that I'm going to do it. But I want you to understand that whatever you do, I can do. I'm not saying that I'm going to do it. That's not what I'm saying. I'm not
so
saying
why
that I'm
going
to
do it.
Exactly. That's your first point because that means you're going to do it. That's your first thing to say.
Because
it's not like, yo, you know what a lot of women do. I don't believe.
You don't start the sentence like, yo, I don't believe in that, but I understand. You start in a sentence like, anything you can do, I can do. So that means you dwell on that ground. I need another drink. Let me make this. You're a round dweller.
Hold
How
on.
Am I round dweller if I'm not cheating, I'm not doing nothing? At the end of the day, let me tell you something.
You my son, but
you gonna let me finish or you gonna keep chatting full chatty?
Well, you talking to like that? You talking like that on this phone?
Yes, I am, because you don't stop. You just go in the little engine that could. Be quiet.
Well, why are you talking like that?
Hold on. Shut the fuck up. Flip, come down. Come down.
Now what are you doing with that phone?
Come down, Flip.
Make me lose my train of thought.
Hold on. But that wasn't nice. Hold on, Flip.
Little engine that could.
Hold on,
you
Flip.
You call me Thomas, nigga?
Flip, hold on. This
That was a success story, though. He made it.
This whole thing about
you ain't let me finish.
if men could do it, I could do it too. That's cool, but the difference with that is that women are judged and looked at. In
yes,
a
women
light.
Are judged. Some women don't care, and at the end of the day, hoes get wiped every day. Now
that's
I'm just
not
saying.
True.
No, yes, it is true.
That's not
yes,
true.
I agree with her.
Yes, it is true.
That's
it's yes, it is true.
Nigga to wife
hoes get wiped every day.
Know.
But I'm not
but he
saying.
Doesn't.
But I'm
don't
not.
Know.
Yes, he does
anyway.
Know.
He don't
you know,
know
how many niggas I know who wiped the girl who was just out there sucking dick.
Yeah, I know.
You know what I mean?
I don't think he knows.
I'm just being 100% honest.
I don't think he knows how deep she's in that realm.
Yes, he does. But listen.
To the last level.
But when I'm.
And for the record, your wholeness is not forgiven, so don't believe
it's
that
not.
Shit.
Never.
Now, my thing is I would never compromise my integrity
Who
or my
that?
Character.
Homegirl said that. That's not true.
I would never compromise my integrity or my character to compete with a man because I'm
Absolutely
not competing
not.
With anybody.
Absolutely.
At the end of the day, I don't have to do none of that.
Fine.
I could
Let's
get my
go,
way
Danny.
Without even
Let's
opening
go,
my legs. You understand?
Salute.
So I will never disrespect myself because Just to get back at you, I'm only hurting me.
Exactly.
And you don't even deserve that energy from me.
Round of applause for that. That's good.
Hold on, get a round of applause.
Shout out to Georgie. Clean it up good. We got the gin in the building.
It ain't cleaning up good. I'm just saying.
Get a round of applause
because,
for that.
But what I was saying about niggas is pussy, meaning that y'all niggas can go around and have sex with this girl, have sex with that girl, whatever. Y'all see a man put hot eyes under a girl post and y'all going crazy. Y'all ready to curse out. Y'all ready to choke her. Y'all ready to do everything over hot eyes.
I don't do that.
A nigga like this shit and y'all wildin'. Let's be clear.
I had the nigga tell him.
Everybody get quiet.
I can't relate to that.
Now everybody quiet.
I had the nigga tell him, step the fuck off.
I can't relate to that.
I need you to stop lying. Now I'm with Mayno. I need you to stop lying.
I can't relate to that. You have proof?
You just made a... We was talking about something that had nothing to do with you and you just had to make it clear up here, right?
What are you talking about?
Earlier. About the conversations me and my brothers were having.
Yes.
For what?
It's a good show.
But why were you making...
It makes a good show because when we go back and forth, it's a good show.
No, but and we didn't because I let it go over my head.
You did let it go over your head. And I chose not to elaborate because I could have. And out of respect for you.
But you know nothing.
Hold on. And I don't want to know anything.
Elaborate.
The thing is about it is that...
Elaborate.
It's two things.
Right.
It's a show and it's personal. This is a show, baby. We got to entertain. We hit entertain. We saw what the last numbers did. We hit entertain. It's an elephant in the room. I got two calls about you flipping Georgia. I got to make it clear.
Make it clear.
I got to make it clear. I really don't want to make it clear, but I got to make it clear.
Make it clear.
You know what I'm saying?
Make it clear.
You know what? You know
clear
what clear
water?
It is. You can see through it.
No, let's see.
No, I can't. You know, it's a little blurry.
What's tap water? What water is see through?
Tap water. No. I need a
Project
censure.
Water? That shit is still.
Tap water. I need a censure.
You got to sit. This is fuzzy.
At the end of the day, when I say something, it's never to disrespect you or put you.
I didn't feel disrespect.
Okay, yeah, that's all part of a show. You know that already. Like, stop acting like you don't know to please your counterparts. You know what I'm saying?
My brothers.
Whatever it is. Brothers, mothers, mothers. Whatever it is. Don't do that. At the end of the day, I'm the outcast here, and you know me.
Outcast?
You know me, so I don't want to have to get there. Because we could do this if you really want to.
And you always lose.
You don't want to go through that door because
you always lose.
Georgie, what's up, Georgie? All right, now I'm about to get at you. What's up?
I'm going to sit back
and let this go.
My thing is this. You know, at the end of the day, you know, I got a lot of love and respect for you. Take that. That's enough.
Bad boy.
That's enough. Take that. Exactly. Puppy, where you at? Take that. Like, the thing, don't try to pull stuff out that you're not going to be able to handle. Let's let that shit go, because I'm here to perform, baby.
Yeah, hold on. Let me just say something.
George,
let me just say something. Hold on. No. Hold on.
He's not even handling nobody.
You know what I noticed about you? You just be talking.
Yep.
You ain't saying shit.
He say nothing.
You ain't saying shit.
You want me to say
you
shit?
You just talking.
All right, let me say,
you
shut just the words. Fuck up because you said...
No, you just
shut
the fuck up because words, you said... Nigga, you just talking.
At the end of the day, she doesn't want to go through a door. I'm the wrong person to go through that door with.
Period. Go through the door.
Nigga, you walk through a door with me, I'm the wrong person. We know too. She's the wrong person for me to walk through that door with.
You're going to go all the way. That's what you're saying.
I'll let the whole clip off, nigga.
Yeah, you know what type of nigga he is.
He going to be crying in the car, not me.
You going to cry in the car.
No, I'm not. Fuck you talking to, nigga.
You gonna cry?
So you never see me cry.
Yo, Rick, you know what type of nigga this nigga is? Let me tell you what type of nigga this nigga is. Yo, he one of them niggas that act like he always got it on him, always gonna do something.
I'm Hummer starting, nigga?
Yes. You one of them niggas. Don't let me go to the car. Don't let me go to the car.
Don't let me go to the car.
What's up, Georgie? What's up?
You one of them niggas.
You stuttering.
Yo, what's that? What I said earlier?
Why you start stuttering already?
He's an alpaca, bro.
My fault. Palm me. Whatever that was.
Alpaca.
What I said earlier. I said something business. What I said earlier.
What about business?
What did I say earlier that you caught on to?
No, your boys, you talking about sister, though, for real.
Palm me.
Why you so
passionate?
And why you so high?
Why your business, nigga? Why your business, nigga? I respect you. What I said earlier that kind of offended you.
Nothing you said offended me at all.
Before we got on camera, you remember what you said, right?
What did I say?
You were just trying to slow everything down. You you got to be careful. You know, you gave a warning. You give warnings.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So we don't want to go against that warning, baby. Warning. We don't.
That's a respectful warning.
And I love you.
It's respectful.
I'm your nigga.
It's always
you my nigga.
Respectful.
I'm your friend.
We cool. And how we cool.
Ooh. Am I your friend?
Let me get that one.
Yes.
All right. Keep it that way.
Whoa, I don't like your tone.
Slow down before you get...
But that's
I don't like your tone. You're saying a lot of my lingo. You're saying a lot of my words, and I need you to stop it.
He's not saying nothing, though. That's the thing. Nothing. Nothing.
You waiting for me to say this, because I know what you're going to do.
Yeah, listen.
You waiting for me because you're going to follow up, right? You always want to be the ender, but I'm waiting for you.
She got an answer for everything.
She does.
She got an answer for everything.
She, right now, you see her hand right there? Look at her hand. She has a whole clip of flips in her hand to let it go. Like, nigga, you did this. You did that.
Flip, let me say this. Let's
I'm gonna knock you out. Don't talk to me, nigga.
You're a married man, though, Flip.
I am.
Be a married man. Be a married man.
I am a married man.
So it's something. You just did that.
Hold on. No. You're a married man. Be a married man.
I am a married man.
Okay, so it's certain things that we just not gonna put out here in the public.
You have children? How many children you have?
Three.
Yeah. So you married with children?
Yes.
Al Bundy.
Yeah, be a good guy. He's a good kid. You understand that?
Hold the fuck up. Yo, my nigga, like, watch your fucking mouth. Like I said, we came across some of the same.
What?
Why you keep bringing that up?
Because I have.
Does it make you feel better? Honestly,
it does. Against him. Against him. Against him.
When
against
y'all
him.
Bring up that you're messing with the same girl.
Kelly's in jail.
He never messed with nobody. I ever messed with in my life. He liked this one girl.
He liked this one girl.
One girl that I knew.
I liked her.
I put in like a
courtesy call or something?
Like a group thing.
You put in a situation.
I put in a situation. It was like a group thing.
Yeah. And I liked her, yes? Yeah. That's where you want to go with it? I let you, you know, it's your show.
You liked her.
I let niggas shine on me. Go ahead.
Come on. No, correct it. You didn't, did you like her?
You liked her.
She was cool.
Yeah, right, cool. And I put in a group thing. And you was just like.
We all did.
It jumped.
No, you didn't. No, you
jumped her. They jumped you.
I was jumped.
I didn't put in a group thing.
All right then. So relax.
I'm not gonna lie myself. Okay. I didn't put in a group thing.
Watch my mic.
I don't.
Yeah, you gotta relax with the mic.
It's between me and him. I'm sorry.
You see Georgia, how you do that? Kitchen talk.
This is kitchen talk.
What I'm saying is that
we all here.
You didn't put in a group thing. Come out. Wait.
Georgie.
When he took
Georgie, I seen you.
When he was in the mix with her, did you told him? You let her.
No. What happened was he was just like, yo, bro, you know such and such. I heard you. And I was like, yeah, that wasn't nothing, man. You know, I had a, you know, she was cool. You know,
yeah, facts. You said that. You know, very respectful.
Did you tell him it was a group thing?
I told him. She told me.
And that was after he told you that, did you say, oh, she with the group thing? Did you try to set up your own group thing?
No, they're not good. They don't look at him like that.
Oh, all right, cool.
I'm a friend zone. I'm friend zone poppy. Friend zone. Yeah.
They don't look at him like that.
So you Rose, never don't do that.
So did you shoot the fair one with her?
Yeah,
101.
No, that's it. You're not God level like that.
Right.
He's checking shows for shit like that.
He ain't get jumped in.
Never.
Can I tell you something? Let me talk to you real quick. Right now, my nigga, I think you need to know your place when you talk to me. Look me in the eye. Like at the end of the day, palm me.
He's a cute little
kid. That camera don't got us? Because I really want
you blocking me though.
Oh, palm me. Can you just slide over? Let's huddle in. Georgie, come in. Stop playing with me. Stop playing my body, nigga. Like, at the end of the day, like, you know what time it is with me.
Shout out to Lola Brooke.
It's up in the stuff.
Shout out to Lola.
It's up, man. We just upped it.
Fuck with Lola.
We just upped it.
She snuck in here, because I just happened to just look up.
What's
up,
Lola?
Right
there. You, it's up for you. Ooh, yeah. Lola, I'm sorry.
I can't wait to the kitchen.
We're going to talk outside. Listen, at the end of the day, I love you. But just know, last thing I'm going to say, when I touch him, it's a difference.
Y'all had a lot of bipolar moments.
So you saving him or you touching him? I don't get what you're saying, though, bro.
Definitely not doing no touching.
You saving him?
They don't even look at him like that.
We don't save him over here.
Yeah,
they don't look at me like that?
No, don't save him.
Don't save him.
You don't want to be saved.
I'm fine with being in the friend zone. I'm the friend zone king.
I need you to stop using that word because stop.
Yo, no, hey, yo, know your role. Stop playing me if I get at you.
I want you to get at somebody because you just up here bluffing.
Please get at somebody.
You love me. Stop it.
Oh,
you love me. Stop it. You love me. Stop it. You love me. Stop it. Like you know what it is with me and you.
What is it?
Not like a relationship. You know what it is.
What
like,
it is.
Don't step out of line for these niggas. You know what it is between me. You know what it is. We know what it is.
What is it, though, Flip?
She know. Look at her face. Everybody turn around, look at her. Turn around, look at her.
Same face she always got.
Her poker face is not good. She know what it is. At the end of the day, listen, slow down. This is between me and my brothers as well. You know what I'm saying? I'm friends.
Somebody get him.
I'm friend zone king.
Here's the thing.
Everybody put me in a friend zone. I'm a married man.
I need everybody who Flip has friend zone to comment when y'all watch this. I need y'all. I need to see y'all in the comments. I want to see who he's friend zoned. I need to hear some stories, please. So
if that's you guys, none of your business.
When you guys watch this, I need y'all to put y'all experiences.
You got friend zoned.
And
you got friend zoned too.
By who?
She got friend zoned by me.
Oh, she wanted something.
No, she didn't want nothing, but she got friend zoned.
What you mean?
She got friend zoned by me. She got friend zoned as well.
Now, only way you can friend zone somebody if they wanted more than more.
She got
than
friend zoned. That's
right?
My nigga.
That's it. The only way is if they want to don't
do that to our Kitchen Talk viewers.
Don't come in here with lies.
The only
man.
Way she could be friend zoned if she wanted more than friendship and then you told her, nah, let's be friends.
Okay.
Rose so correct Marks. That.
I'll let you tell it.
No, I'm not telling
you. I'll let y'all tell me.
I'm going to give you the definition of friend zone.
All right, that's my definition of friend zone is a little bit different, but.
What is it?
Elaborate. Go ahead.
She got friend zone.
How?
Everybody get friend zone with
how
me.
How I got friend zone?
Explain.
Explain.
You know, you my nigga. I don't like the fact that you coming up here and not being honest, bro. And listen, for me to you, though, right?
What do you want me to say?
Hold on. I just, see, I'm a little upset with you, bro.
My thing is that you got to learn? You got to learn when something is put together from the jump. You see that comes with experience.
What? So we said before you came.
Me and my man talked.
I wasn't
here with him earlier. All
right.
Well, exactly. Me and him talk. He know what's on my.
Different day.
No.
He set you up.
It's not about that, Georgia. Like, he set you up. Good. At the end of the day,
me and you good, but you keep making little funny comments.
It's not to disrespect you, but
I don't feel disrespected. I don't take anything personally, honey. Bum. Listen,
don't call me that.
Let me tell you something.
Friend zone.
Listen, beautiful. Let me talk. Come here, beautiful. Let me talk to you.
That shit don't work on me, nah.
Come here, beautiful. Let me talk to you.
She tell everybody.
Listen, sweetheart.
She called me sweetheart.
Listen.
She called me sweetheart.
We all here together.
She never called me honey bun.
We
all here
together. We got 3 minutes.
We got three minutes.
What was it? Honey bunch or honey bun?
Honey bun.
What was it? Honey bun.
You okay?
Honey bun.
You okay? You seem a little parched. Honey bun.
No, I'm good. I got water. I'm always hydrated. Always.
HB. Honey
bun. You should never call me honey bun. I knew it for
you
years.
You need to drink some ice?
No, I got ice.
You look like you're a little dehydrated.
I never dehydrated. Oh, I
make you nervous?
I knew for over 10 years you never call me honey bun.
You talk a lot, though, but you don't do no talking. I like that. You talk a lot. She calls you honey bun.
What does that mean?
I called them beautiful.
That doesn't,
I called them sweetheart.
That doesn't mean anything.
You know how that go.
I don't know how anything goes.
You know how it go.
I don't know how anything goes.
It's all right, beautiful. You're a beautiful man, and it's okay. Mm. You stay beautiful. Sweetheart.
I'm handsome.
Damn.
I don't go for that beautiful shit. I'm handsome.
He got titties, though.
What?
He got titties.
What?
I do.
You do, too.
No, I don't.
You do.
You got 2 minutes.
you got two minutes to ask some questions. I don't see. This is why. Y'all two get on my damn nerves.
I'm sorry.
Y'all two get on my damn
nerves. You know it won't happen again. We won't happen.
You just said me, too. You just said me, too.
You got a little...
It's muscle.
Okay. I'm getting muscles as well, but don't worry about it.
I'm a part of the little titty committee. I'm all right.
Yo, I'm right. At the end of the day, man, like I said, friend zone. Nope.
I'm a B cup though, but ain't nothing wrong with that.
It's okay. You got friend zone.
Yes, I did.
And it's not a problem, man. I would say I got friend zone, but that never happened to me. It's okay.
You got friend zone.
You got
as well.
Friend zone. We just had a whole segment about it.
By Ashanti,
but not a lot of people. He getting friend zone.
Not yet, definitely. Ashanti friend zone me. Yeah, never.
That's kind of different.
That's a fact. That definitely happened.
That food looking good. I'm just saying.
It is looking good. Fripp, you're not eating tonight.
I don't want to eat.
You're not.
What you trying to say about the cooks?
I don't want
to
eat.
Why not? You trying to say about the cooks?
No. Shout out to them. I went to school with one of them.
Shout out to Alyssa Jolie.
Alyssa Jolie. I went to school with her.
Shout out to Queens Flip for coming back. This is gonna be his last time here.
Thank God.
this is Queens Flip last time in this house.
Thank you.
Oh, in the house?
In this home.
So stuck in the house?
At Kitchen
Talk. So we have our cookouts and all that? He's not invited?
No, he's invited. Still invited. That's still my brother. Still my little brother.
I'm good. I don't want to go nowhere where you at.
That's a lie.
No, but I thank you guys for having me again.
Yeah, it's all good. We love you, bro. But
thank you very much. All of you.
Let me ask you something, since you like an internet sensation. So let me ask you a question, because this is always something that I think about, right? Because I feel like I don't need nobody to validate me.
I agree.
I don't need the internet to validate me. I don't need certain type of people to validate me. I feel like I am who I am no matter what. No matter what the weather is, no matter what the destination is, what the environment is. Do you feel like you need people to validate you? Because we live in a time where on the internet, everybody's doing things to, I guess, impress people.
Go viral.
Go viral for validation.
No, I don't.
You You're not looking for validation.
Nah.
So you just do the shit that you do just for no reason.
I do it for because I like to do it.
Mm. Okay.
Why? The reason for everything. Why?
I like to be an entertainer. It has opened new doors for me, and that's it became a career. So that's what I choose to do.
Okay.
And what do you do? Like, what do you do?
I'm just me.
No, what is me? Like, what do you do?
I have a podcast. Flip the script.
No, fuck that. What do you do? I seen you doing a lot of shit, like going places, fucking shit up, getting beat up. I seen a lot of that happening.
All that was stage.
Listen. Oh, okay. Nice.
Right.
Nice.
Nah, some of it wasn't, but at the end of the day, that was the old me.
Oh,
yeah. We manifest into something. I mean, it turned out it started as one thing and it just.
You said manifest it?
Yeah.
He used the word. Okay.
Come on, hold on.
Yeah. Remember.
Good. Manifest it. Use the word.
I'm sorry. At the end of the day, even at the end of the day, and I want to say this wholeheartedly. Like, I love you. I know I talk shit to you.
Yep.
Shout out to you because. And let me shout out Aunt Deb because she's gonna G-check me.
Yeah.
Because and the thing is, I can't give in to pressure from a Brooklyn nigga.
So you do realize that you came on the show and didn't really keep it 100. You didn't keep it all the way 1,000 on the show.
I think I did.
No, you didn't. But we're going to save
it. And we passed that. But at the same time is that I definitely want to thank you guys. You guys are amazing. All three of you. You guys are a beautiful team. And I wish one day I could.
Wow. You hear the violins in the back?
Yeah. I wish one day I could. Don't do that, baby. Don't do that, baby girl.
Baby girl.
Don't do that, baby girl.
Just put a different voice on just now.
Yeah, don't do that. Don't do
you
that.
You want a baby girl because I call them beautiful.
Yeah, definitely.
Honey
it's
bun.
Not going to work. Honey bun. Honey bun. HB.
Can I ask you a question?
HB.
Yes, you can. Let me put on my voice, too. Go ahead.
Yeah. I mean, I've heard you tell a lot of people that, so... This is why, usually, probably before, like,
what did you hear?
I just heard a lot. Listen, last year, like in 2018, that would have meant the world to me. And we ain't going, it's up and stuck. You would have called me Honey Bun there. Nigga, I would have been, now, saw your last couple of games. It wasn't really impressive.
Games? But, who plays games?
At the end of the day.
You know what, Flip, though? The thing about it is this, though. Right, you're good at what you do, but yeah. You don't.
Hold on, I got it right now.
Georgie.
Hold on, I got it right now, Mano. So
he want this, Georgie.
Didn't you say you don't seek validation or anything?
Of course, yes.
So why did you have to tell me about me just now? Mm. Even though it wasn't true, but why did you have to tell me that it didn't work or that my games, quote unquote, they don't work? Why did you have to prove that? Right now, you didn't have to say anything. But you chose.
Where am I seeking validation from? Sorry.
I'm asking you. You say you don't seek validation from anything, right?
No, I mean, but where does the validation come up from by me saying a comment about you?
Because I feel like you're trying to prove something right now. You're trying to prove that I don't affect you. Usually when you say, forget that. You can talk about whatever you want to talk about right now.
That's not nice. Listen, let's catch your talk. We out of here. Episode 8.
You don't end us.
You don't end us,
but. Well, I just want to say I want to thank you. All jokes aside, shout out to Georgie.
Yeah, all jokes aside.
Georgie, shout out to Georgie. We did a video that's doing extremely good. I got two
she
calls.
She smoked you.
She did. She did a great job. I mean, shout out to Aunt Deb.
Shout out to Aunt Deb.
Shout out to motherfucking Mano. I mean, people love the video.
Shout out to Alyssa Jolie.
Shout out to Alyssa Jolie. I went to school with the Holy Trinity.
You know what I mean? Male.
Yeah, it should look good.
It do.
And the thing is, I want to just say that, man. I want everybody to keep it to work, man. And I leave it at that. I think that we all.
Episode 8. Flipping say shit.
Double O.
Kitchen Talk.
Shout out to Lola Brooks.
Shout out to Lola. Yeah, hustle hard, teammate. It's all love.
Watch my hook.
Oh, it's over.
If my drink would have fell, would have been a problem. Fuck the mic.
Oh, your drink would have fell, would have been a problem. Mano, you know what it is, man.
You drop shit when you went to his podcast?
Nah, he was very respectful. He was extremely respectful. He was extremely appreciative. And I love him.
And we out.
Hit us up.
Hey, yo, episode motherfucker 8.
Hit us up on the
catch
IG.
Me at episode 12. You know what I'm saying? We're going to be, episode 12. Got a surprise for Mano. His birthday. Wait, hold the fuck up. When that nigga birthday?
It's in a couple more weeks.
Oh.
We just said we out. Why you still going? We out, y'all.
Yo, it's Queen Flip.
Yo, listen, Justice League.
Yeah, hit him, Ricky Hustle Hard.
Your favorite
At your favorite tomboy.
At your favorite tomboy. And yo, look, listen, Q-U-E-S-E.
At me, no hustle hard.
Catch me back on Kitchen Talks in 4 weeks.
12? You can cut it.